Good afternoon. This is an unprecedented video. That's Professor Frank Griffin in the 1,000 leading Freemasons in the world. And that is a deer with Joni's disease. That's a disease up the arse. Yeah, which comes into the royal story for the Freemasons all the time. And they're just below him. Okay. So there's Gus Grissom, the legendary man who screwed up in the space program. Yeah, he's the one that jumped out of the pod when it was gonna get buried in the ocean. Okay, he's the right stuff in America. There's other Freemasons. Yeah, the whole world is run as a joke. So that's Frank Griffin, who's the head of the biochemistry department when I was there, and I was his great friend. Got him to speak several times, and in return he chaired the inquest into my bad behaviours and my dismissal. Yeah, I'm going to show you all of the culprits. Yeah, so he's a fellow of the Royal Society now. Yeah, that's all of them work for the Royals that still own that country. Okay, and there's a guillotine reference, and I've explained to you in yesterday's video how the whole of this lot dismember the whole of the world's capability. So I'm going to now engage in that controlled experiment that I told you about the other day. Let me get rid of that tab that we've now used. I'm tempted to play Shania Twain's inspiring music, but that does not impress me much in the leopard skin, because Shania now owns vast tracts of land in that poor impoverished country, and she's from America, yeah, out there to be a land grabber with the assistance of Helen Clark, her closest friend. And that's Helen Clark, the sexual deviant who was in Intel and was working for, I think it was the Russian organization. So she and Putin served for a long time in New Zealand, and she is in all sorts of sexual deviant things, and she's married to a gay man, and the whole of the story is really sick. And her gangbang, her gangbang rapes, yeah, because she's a prostitute, led to her, you know, urinary dysfunction for quite a long period in her life. I was on her Facebook site. She's now just a propagandist and a false news person. Okay? And that was Hayley Westenra, who sang for George W. Bush. And the joke about her being a goddess is that she's on the Odyssey, like me, at the same time as I am. Her music is really inspiring. Okay? But she's on both sides now, because she went to sing for George W. Bush. Okay. Right then. So, let's get rid of that. And she might sang with the blind singer too. Let's get on with the story. Okay. First, I'm going to go into that controlled experiment that I told you about the other day. This is a letter from my colleague, John Ashton. And sadly, John has contracted cancer. So basically the story is that OTAGO booted me out. I think I got $25,000, which is not worth a lot. You divide that by three and you get the net worth of that. Yeah, and this is the letter from John Ashton, who's an associate professor when I left, and part of the story is that I got him promoted and we got his pay risen. Okay, so this is the letter that I got from him on the 6th of December 2015, and I want to see, the gods have given me extraordinary powers to speak out against the injustices across the world, and I want to see whether or not John gets better, yeah, in the light of the fact that he's now come back on my side. That's the Macbeth story that happens to me every day. One of them's missing. Right then. Okay, so, dear George, this is John
Ashton from Pharmacology Otago writing. I hope this is a live email account and that you're still checking it. I've wanted to write to you for some time, but as you'll see, I've been a little distracted. In mid-2013, I was diagnosed with adenocarcinoma of the lung as a lifetime non-smoker that had metastasized to become bilateral and multinodular, with a very grim prognosis, around 9 months median survival time, less than 5% to 5 years. Two different regimens of cytotoxics had little effect on the cancer, but in early 2014 I was fortunate enough to have my biopsy tested for an ALK mutation by Mark McKeague in Auckland, which came back positive, and I was able to get on Pfizer's compassionate expanded access program for crizotinib. Yeah, this is the drugs that I've been telling you about. And in the cancer world, it's a huge target to take on, and the costs of those can be quite formidable. But John's been lucky enough to get sponsorship from one of the pharma companies. Okay, this had a dramatic effect, a complete radiographic response, and Pfizer is the company that the head of psychiatry yeah, who's the Nazi who's made the videos, and his name is Kurt Krause. Yeah, he's in the Odessa film, and that's the real Nazi Kurt Krause. This one came from Texas. Yeah, well, the Rothschilds have their interests. Yeah. Okay, so Pfizer's compassionate expanded access program for crizotinib. This had a dramatic effect, a complete radiographic response, and John has been in remission and taking it for nearly 22 months. That's great news, okay? Almost all of my correspondence, yeah, to the decent people that I write to, yeah, I believe that they were all decent people, but when you see the names and the linkages to the world's wealthiest people that I now appreciate, and all of the laundering tools and all of the locations for the professoria out there, I now understand entirely that none of New Zealand belongs to anybody in New Zealand. As you can imagine, I went through a period of tying up loose ends, making contact with old friends and acquaintances, putting old differences to rest, and always meant to contact you better late than never. I want to tell you a few things. First, I was never part of the departmental review process that led to your leaving New Zealand. I thought you were treated appallingly, and I'm still ashamed to have been indirectly associated with it. When asked about your leadership at the review interview, I spoke in praise of you, though it did not occur to me to defend you because I didn't know what was at stake. The second thing I want to do is to thank you for your part in my career. I remember when I had made a bad career choice and ended up with the Spinal Cord Research Society, and I thought my career was essentially ruined. And I remember vividly that upon hearing this, you rang me at my home and helped me out of the hole, offering me a teaching role at the department. You then made critical introductions for me, such as to Michelle Glass, that's in the Auckland team, that we've made videos about on the stem cells, and Michelle is an expert in stem cell technology. Okay, that resulted in my landing a grant that launched my career proper. I remember you primarily as the man who was passionately interested in science and in the development and nurturing of new and young scientists. I want to belatedly thank you for what you did on behalf of myself, but also my family. As for me, my three PhD graduates are all doing well. Phil Brownjohn at Cambridge, Jack at Manchester, Simran, who's my friend and he's quite loyal to me still, which is really refreshing. He used to work in the drug toxicity unit, yeah, where I'm an expert in. They have no funding for that now. And the woman who got her professorship there, I will not tell you her name because it must be quite distressing what happened to her. She was given the professorship the same month that she was chucked out of the institution. Yeah, token gestures. Yeah, and that is the drug safety unit that is a legend for finding out about thalidomide and all of those things about the statins that are in the news this week, because I've exposed the chief pharmacist and the chief medical officer in Scotland as massive fraudsters, with every doctor across our country who gets 40% of their salary to dismember their patients. That's 40 grand a year to give too many drugs for pharma. Yeah? And for the dismemberment of everyone that ends up in the care homes. Okay? As for me, my three PhD graduates are doing okay, doing well. Phil Brown-John at Cambridge, Jack at Manchester, and Simran the drug safety man with Martin Kennedy. Yeah? All of the massive families are in the professoriate. Okay, and those are the Illuminati families and the super wealthy banking dynasties. I'll show you more about that later on. Friends of Omar Sharif in some of the world's most twisted movies about British people growing abroad and helping the locals. Yeah. The Maoris in New Zealand are famed for their middens. Yeah, that's the waste collection system in the places where they were taken down by the new imperialist invaders, and they were terrible because they were cannibals. As for me, yeah, after the shock of my cancer, I've gradually worked up my research to the point where I have a functioning lab again and fully expect to have quite a few good years yet. My boys, Stuart and William, are now 14 and 18 and are smart, healthy boys. I hope you two are doing well. John must have forgotten about the third one, who maybe you never met. I sometimes find myself wondering about you with concern about the impact of events here on you personally and professionally, and I do hope that you are well. Okay? If I do not get a chance to, if I get the time, I will show you the letter that told John that I've never been better and I've never been more inspired by the work that I'm now doing, because what I'm doing is trying to get pharmacology and the medication of patients all over the globe based on rational decision making. It's ever so tough the way that pharma and Pfizer were the sponsors for that psychiatrist who came and monitored me in those last 2 or 3 months with young Connolly, my disloyal student. And that is Adam Errington's thesis. Oh, sorry, I've given the game away. That's Adam Errington, the disloyal guy whose mum works for the P&O Empire with George W. Bush and Michael Moore, MP, no longer MP, all of them totally disgraced. Okay, so let me disgrace my colleagues at OTAGO one by one. Okay, that's the senior colleagues. First, I'll show you the Department of Pharmacology, where I was the boss. Okay, and, oh no, so this is some of the hits that you get when you now look for my wife. Yeah, and there's her colleague at Otago Polytechnic, that's on the board of Ernst & Young, Cullen Kilshaw. Yeah, and he's on the board of Ernst & Young right up to 2005, when my wife was working for a care. Okay, that's relatively unimportant, but I'm just showing you that when the Brits come in and they have insight into financial services, like Dr. Stephen Andrew Hancock's and Philip Giorgio, that you can make a fortune out of £100 and turn it into £274,000 in the same corrupted share deal. Yeah, and that is the FDI World Dental Press Limited, run by Dr. Stephen Hancock's OBE. Okay, that's Team Valerie. Okay, and you can see that my campaigns to enlighten people about people named John Cook, who live right next door to Rory Bremner potentially, are linked in with John Robertson Wright, the trillionaire at the HSBC, and who lives in Ednam, where the Church of Scotland is run from, where the vicar has healthcare problems. Okay, he's now gone back to Fife. I should not say that because it upsets my dad. Thank you to my dad's mate for meeting me in the supermarket last night and confirming that you are part of the Fat Lips dynasty, and all of them were really dangerous, sad bastards and profiteer from different continents, where they used to be the Governor Generals, like places like New Zealand. Frederick Anderson Goodwin interlocking with John Cook. Okay, let's get rid of that. Okay, and that is Matt Carter on the board of BHP Billingham, yeah, who then takes over as head of HR at Otago Polytechnic to dismember it and asset strip it. And he is actually a Kiwi. Okay, so that is just the Polytechnic, though, ever so low life. Right then, so let's get rid of that one. Not sure what the next one is. I think that will be the Department of Pharmacology at Otago. Oh, they've taken it down. Okay, so there's the mail shot, and there's our this is the Department of Pharmacology. Oh, snap, we're not allowed to see them. Yeah, it was working okay just a few minutes ago. Yeah, and the people that are there are all members of out of America, of those five fraternities that I referred to in yesterday's video about the DuPont pharmaceutical and explosive experts, yeah, with those 6,000 subsidiaries registered in those explosive factories, yeah, in all of the countries that win the Peace Prize. Okay, oh snap, something went wrong while displaying the web page. So Rhonda Rosengren, yeah, with the Alpha, Kappa, Beta, Gamma, all that American bullshit, yeah, she took over from me as acting head. And then Cynthia Darlington, yeah, the same stories about Lord Darlington and Superman, who broke his back and was in the film about the remains of the day. Yeah, the whole of my life is amazing. I don't know whether the gods have planned out the whole story, that almost every story in world history is mine. Okay, but let's have a look and see if we can see some of the mugshots, because all of these people are mentored through all of my time in New Zealand. And they turn on you ruthlessly. And the previous head was called Jackson, because that is one of the innocent presidents in America too, and he got booted out using the bums rush technique that they used on me. Otago University, Department of Pharmacology and Toxicology. Okay, and that's the building, yeah, that's the top floor where they had the Christmas party, and my PA Sonia got her tits out there, and we can see the search for Sonia later on. Yeah, and we can see the tits in the Devil's Advocate movie, yeah, because she's a dead ringer for Connie Nielsen. And the dinner lady when I got to Kelso, it's amazing. Okay, study pharmacology and toxicology, our people, that's the one I lit up before, it may well still be blocked. Okay, the address for our building was Frederick Street, yeah, and we had a earthquake there in 2000. Oh, we're going to get to look at some of the people. Okay, so I'm not sure what that means, I'm not sure what the motto is, I was a bit down on those things, but I insisted in having an Arthurian round table in the boss's office. Okay, those are all newcomers. There's John, he's a really nice guy, and you can see how he's appreciated my input over that time. Okay, there's a beard. Yeah, those are all new people. There's Cynthia, that's the woman Darlington who hosted the Congress for the warmongers when Superman, Christopher Reeves, stood up and said, we will do not want in World War II to work with amateurs like the British aristocracy. We want to professionalise the campaign, which is why Christopher Reeves broke his neck when he fell off his piezo horse. Yeah, watch that movie on Putlocker for free and see the reasons why God gives people spinal injuries that are intractable, and then he drives them into the stem cell sector, yeah, which John's friends work in, which may well help to cure it over the course of time. I believe that will take several centuries if they are able to do it at all, if ever. Okay, and there's one of the youngsters that also I brought into the department. I remember there was a terrible fuss about me charging expenses because I took him to dinner. Okay? And there's one of the... that's Irene. She was really quite almost as powerful as the head of the department. And I was dead scared of her for all of my time there. Irene Hall. And there's Ivan and Joan. She worked with me at Sunderland University. Okay? And there's the American idiot who will not talk to me now. None of them will talk to me. That's Steve Carr. Yeah? The man who took me fishing and got me attracted into New Zealand. Because at that time, I'm totally trivial. Yeah? I spend all my time in the test tube, or I spend all my time on the riverbank. And I did not really appreciate. And everywhere I went to seminars because I soak up information on everybody else's topics. And everybody all across that university was ever so intimidated by that because they thought I was pinching their ideas and I was making a fortune from the pharmaceutical industry. Yeah, my pension is virtually worthless. Okay? Right then. So, and let's find Rhonda. Yeah, there she is. Okay, so she's from the American side of the world. Yeah, and she's got all those alpha, kappa, gamma things. And she was the person that became the head of department after I was forced out. Okay, and there's Ivan. He's a really nice guy. He's got my boat now. And all of those beautiful things about New Zealand that made it really a beautiful place to live. And all of the Freemasons like Frank fuck it up all of the time. It's still in the hands of the monarchy. And that's the BHP Billington and all of the massive mining interests that they have down there, the British Royals. Okay, there's Paul Smith. He's a nice guy too. Both of them, he and his missus, work on tinnitus. And I now understand that tinnitus is a tool for the gods to give people a conscience, potentially lifelong. Yet that's ringing in your ears. Every time a bell rings, an angel gets his wings. And all of these people think that there's a scientific solution and a cure for that, and that they're more powerful than the gods in the sky, which I think is why John got the rethink and has written to me and corresponded with me. Yeah? Because he sees, yeah, now, that people can be inspirational and they can work. Yeah? And all of the things that I've learned about medicine and pathology since I left New Zealand are actually inspiring for me. It just shows me the power of gods, and that's why I'm so God-fearing, and that's why I'm prepared to engage in an experiment like this. If I die tomorrow, then I suspect that I have made the wrong moral decision on exposing this case and how New Zealand is run as a subsidiary of Great Britain and the empire upon which the sun will never set. That one just joined Rhonda's cancer lab as I was leaving. He's French. That has sinister connotations in every story I tell you, but not this one. I don't know anything about him. And here are the people that work in Paul's team. Yeah, Paul successfully raised funds for that tinnitus research all through his time. Many of the students now are in the UK. Mines are in Oxford. They were in Wales, and Adam Errington is still in Wales. And he worked for a long time with one of my colleagues at St George's, and that is Vincenzo Crunelli in the Italian mafias. But all of them are so besotted with their science that none of them are prepared to confront the fact that all of those institutions that they work in Britain now, are stealing £60,000, yeah, for the honours degree that they got for free. Yeah, and I don't know how much of that goes into the members of the Royal Society in New Zealand, but let's get on with it. Okay, let's shut down the Otago staff base. I think that's it. Okay, so that's the department that I was head of for 6 years, and I enjoyed every minute of it. Yeah, even the fighting at the end,
Yeah, I've got them pinned. Yeah, I'm totally innocent. I'm totally committed to my career and helping my colleagues with my career, and that's why I attended everybody else's seminar programs. And they think because I've got the contract with Schwartz Pharma in Europe that I'm just a fat cat and soaking it up and filing patents all over the world. I have never filed a single patent in the whole of my life. I've helped the pharmaceutical companies to file them because that was the terms of the contract we took on, which were breached by Otago University when they chucked me out. And they use a thing called the departmental review to do that. Okay, let's get some of the characters into it, because they're really big characters. Okay. So, I'm not sure. Staff management. Okay, so this is my boss when I left. She was my colleague and my equal when I joined them. She's the head of the anatomy department. Yeah, that is Helen Nicholson, and her husband is the Burns Club reader. Yeah, and she worked with and took me to parties with people who went to Japan to work because they got sick of begging for their funding in New Zealand. Helen's from Bristol, where the money laundering happens. Yeah, and her husband is from Musselburgh, where I'm in touch with the political people because it's the serious fraud office. Yeah, but even that is a lie. There is no serious fraud office in Scotland. All of the serious fraud is globalised through these networks of people that are prepared to desert their new country and work in the Royal Society for the old country. Okay. Her husband was a nice guy, and both of the kids are now in England paying for the better education, because reputationally it's much more important to go to Harvard or Oxford or Cambridge or Yale or any one of those warmongering institutions that I've profiled for you. Okay, so she's now the dean, and she's the one, yeah, that led me into the departmental review and the honey trap that got me chucked out, like the previous man, Professor Jackson, who was chucked out immediately following the internal review. Okay, and the score for my department went up so that we were the best scoring department in all of the medical schools in three. So when I joined Otago University, they were four out of seven universities, so they were fourth in the league table. Yeah, when I left they were the best, and we had the biggest increase in our score for academic productivity and research output. Yeah, and we competed for the best neuroscience, and we got to the top of that battle, and all of it is totally meaningless. All of the funds disappear. Okay. Yeah, and she's the person that would not allow me to go and see the man, Don Robertson, who was her boss. And that is Robertson, just above Hoyk, which has been flooded for the last 3 weeks. And he now had retired to the outback in Australia, maybe for reputational reasons, because all of the terms of that review were breached, which is why I got the 25 grand. And my wife was supporting me then. Yeah. And as soon as she gets insight into the fact that I'm onto the frauds of Otago Polytechnic and Mark Carter and the MI6 people that worked with her in the Department of Human Resources at Otago Polytechnic, under the man Kerr, that immediately my wife entered that institution, she began to work for. Okay, so that's Helen. And I've written to her and Helen Clark in the same emails, pleading with them to come clean on how the world could be a much better place if the central banks in that world were in the hands of the countries. Yeah, the central bank is located in, but there's no way that that can happen until people like John Ashton get on my side and the students become aware of what I'm trying to do
to expose the Brits that are working in the professoriate in New Zealand. Let me show you some more of them. Okay, Centre for Production and Genomics. So you understand the gene, yeah, and you pretend that that will have a massive impact on the disease process. The gods are much more powerful. Okay, so bye bye Centre for Reproduction and Genomics. And I think she's now stepped up again from being the dean. And they were building a new building, yeah, and all of it is the most difficult man to find was her predecessor as the dean, because he's Dr. Jones, and I've not been able to find him again. Only a sentence on his retirement, and he had the heart attack too, just after we left. And I've still got a tent peg from his tent in my garage, and that's the tent peg joke about driving the tent peg into the cranium of the victim in the lovely, lovely Christian Bible. Yeah, and in the Odyssey movie about Jason and the Argonauts. Yeah, that's Phineas in those stories. Okay. So, we've got another. Oh. So, who's this one? Otago staff. This is the banking dynasty that is the Tuckers. And he's the one that had me to dinner. And he had his dog, yeah, with a crisp in it. Yeah, and all of it is a joke. So, Ian Tucker was the head of the pharmacy department. And along here we've got my PA Sonia, who gets her tits out. Yeah, I think it was the first or the second year that I joined them. Sonia was lovely. She's lovely to look at. Yeah, I cannot remember her surname, and she's been married two or three times. Yeah, she was tremendously loyal to me until all of them turned on me. Yeah. Yeah, and she lived locally, and she was a very spirited person. Yeah, and she was emotionally very unstable, yeah, when they were beginning to hit on me. But I now appreciate all of that is the we will do war by deceit thing. She then worked for the Proctor, that's the disciplinary sector of the university, okay? Tucker was the one who first bailed out of my decent NZ email listing, yeah, because he's in a legacy of the banking dynasty, okay, and he makes drugs and he tries to make profits from the drugs that he makes, okay, so he's in the Brain Health Research Centre, yeah, and I don't know whether or not he's emeritus now, but the Tuckers are a massive financial dynasty, okay. And yeah, his children were in Australia and they were classical musicians, I believe, or artists. Okay, all of that is now a no-go area academically, because you cannot make back in the humanities sector the profits that you can make in these profiteering efforts. So he delivers the formulation and the bioactivity for human and veterinary new drugs, okay? Right, so let's shut him down. And here we see yeah, one of the Christchurch people. Do you get that? That's where the massive earthquake was. And he's got a lovely head of hair. I don't know whether or not Professor Tucker has formulated a drug to keep his hair like that. His name is that and that. Okay? He was really friendly, I thought, until they all turned on me and all of them were celebrating my departure, yeah, in a massive dinner, yeah, just before we left in the summer for them of 2009 as we approached Christmas Day. Because remember, they're on the other side of the world, and our winters are their summers. And and most of them live in the little huts that I told you about, and they all still burn wood fires. Yeah, and all of the houses, even for David Jones, my boss, the dean, yeah, from South Africa, who I believe is the David Jones that has been disappeared, because he's the Dr. Jones joke, that's the Indiana Jones jokes, yeah, that runs the G4S subsidiaries, and he's a friend, and we'll see him later on. No, we won't, because I cannot find him now. He's been disappeared. He wore, all the time that I was there, the horsey boots that are the icon for the Piso family. Okay, from South Africa. Thank you to the South African people for the fascinating discussion about how the ghettos are expanding and how the poor people are ever so poor in South Africa still. It was a really, really lovely chat that we had with you and your young daughter. Okay, it was lovely, lovely, lovely that people can talk openly about political issues without being persecuted for it. And that's Sainsbury Supermarket, where I persecuted Lord Sainsbury for his sins as the science minister and driving people into the obesity epidemic. So that's the Barclays from the Channel Islands in the Professoria in Christchurch, where the massive earthquake occurred. Right then, yeah, Christchurch, the whole of it, called the English City for a laugh, run by John Key, the hedge fund manager, and some of the Barclays in the professoriate. And he's a gastroenterologist. Okay, an arbitrary pick, yet there are dozens of them, all linked in and all aspiring to be fellows of the Royal Society. Okay? There are three centres. Mine's was the biggest score improvement of all of the medical school between Wellington and Dunedin. And I'm totally ashamed that I thought that at that time was ever so important. Micro Otago, yeah, Frank Griffin, my best mate in life before he chaired the censure panel convened by Cynthia Darlington and Rhonda Rosengren, Pi Kappa Alpha Delta and all that bullshit. Yeah, that's the stuff that Britney sings about. There's Frank, lovely warm smile, he's a fucking golfer. Yeah, and he's a specialist in up the rear issues too, okay? Not gastroenterology, he's into Yone's disease in the deer community, and he's been gifted. Let's show you him on this tab, okay? And this is the microbiology department that David Jones used to be the boss at before he became the dean and my boss. Yeah, and he's the man that interviewed me. And that was the year that I travelled to New Zealand with the Paralympics teams, and the planes were 4 hours late. Yeah, because that's the launch of all of the jokes about the Paralympics now being the residues of the world's people, because the bloodlines have been almost extinguished of the good people. Yeah, and all of the things that lead to Elton John as a homosexual being able to have virgin births using the technologies that all of these people live for and worship, basically. Okay, so Frank's an Irishman, his accent is very, very broad. Okay, applied molecular immunology, animal disease, and this is where Glenn, the scientist who was the immunology expert, yeah, who wanted, yeah, to get everybody injected for everything, yeah, and to run the programs that they run on trying to get rid of polio and issues like that, because it inflicts as an act of God on the people that are the likes of Bill Gates. Okay, so I don't know if he's still active. Yeah, because I've made videos on him before, And there's his lab group, and we will not show you them, but that's what he works on. Okay. Viral issues up the arse of the deer. Paratuberculosis. Yeah, and that is a massive pathogen for poor people in ghettos. Okay. Yeah, do you get the picture? And when I went to India, it was dreadful. That's where they hang off the side of the commuter train. They get to Mumbai, and then you see the real wealth divide that is the blight of the African world too. Yeah, the conversation last night was ever so insightful. They did not know, though, whether or not the things that we see in the Out of Africa movie are still happening. In other words, can the Queen still evict people from those massive estates that were portrayed in that film by Robert Redford, the man who makes the American movies on freedom? Yeah, that's the electoral fraud in the Watergate building. Okay, and the quiz show program, where you see that they get the corrupted people in America, not the war criminals who get left alone, but the people who get the answers to the quiz before they enter it. That's the Sally Magnuson dynasty jokes. Yeah, cheating, all of that is trivia, and that becomes the biggest crime that America commits. I'll show you what Frank does in the Masons later on. Okay. So, this is the head of physiology. She's from Bristol too. Her office was a real mess. Okay, her name is Pat Cragg. That's another Patricia in my life. That's the patricians in Rome. Yeah, and my wife's divorce solicitor, who used to be the legal divorce solicitor for the council, and has our net worth in Hoyk has risen from £50,000 when we came home in 2000. Not sure what this one's going to open up for us. I think it's a Google Images of Pat Cragg. Yeah, her office was a total mess. Okay, and I don't know if she's still in power, but physiology was the home for my mate from Cambridge. Yeah, who we played ping pong with. And my student at that time, who joined the department and married into an academic, was Li Ping. That's the Li financial dynasty. Okay, I had no insight into any of these things when I went there or when I left. There's Professor Barclay again. Poor Pat only has the one image. And I think she was an associate professor, but she was good at keeping people at arm's length when they fall out with each other, which is the only thing that I was asked to do through all of my time there. All of my scientific skills totally worthless. Yeah, and everybody has massive arguments about what they're allowed to do and what they're not allowed to do, and all the health and safety things that come out of the Barclays UK. Yeah, all of it is blighting even the Kiwis. They're very spirited people, but they're now, you know, bound down by all of those regulations and the rules that the Brits enforce on them, Pat. Okay, also a Bristolian. That's the money laundering centres and the slaving centres that we tell you about, like Liverpool. Yeah, and the Liverpool people are so besotted with profiteering from the new drugs that they commission there, yeah, because they're on the boards that choose the drugs that are up to speed, and they get rid of the old generics and replace them with the ultra expensive drugs. Yeah, and the Liverpool departments get poor academic scores because they don't have time yet for their because of their profiteering efforts at that interface to build an academic profile like me, which improved the reputation of Otago University from fourth to first. And I was only there for 6 years. Okay, and here we've got, let's get Pat out of the way. So she was she's the same department that Alan Herbison joined, and he's a global superstar from Southland, where everybody lives in huts. And here's my mate, the religious man. Okay, and it's quite spooky. Okay, so that's Cliff Abraham, the head of the neuroscience community when I was there. Really nice guy. Yeah. Until they get me thrown out. And the last meeting that I went to in Queenstown was the one where they had the massive earthquake, and everybody was getting a little bit cool with me, yet because I go to their seminars and they think I'm a profiteer. Yet because I work for the pharmaceutical industry as a pharmacologist, and we help to get their new drugs in epilepsy launched and marketed. Okay, and the psychiatrist that came in from Pfizer, yeah, he uses the drugs that we use to give to the people for pain relief in sub-Saharan Africa. That is ketamine. He was trying to develop ketamine as an antipsychotic agent. It's totally twisted. Yeah, and that is Kurt Cruz, who my wife gave me a row for not giving up our house to him when he first arrived. And his son was unhinged psychiatrically, and all of it is totally twisted, and the gods run the whole show. Okay, and this is quite spooky, because this is Cliff Abraham, and Abraham is in the next picture that I'm going to show you. Okay, he's a nice guy. They had a really good community in neuroscience, and they shared their time with the drug discovery team, and they had their annual meeting in Queenstown, and it was a junket that the likes of which I've never enjoyed since I came home. Yeah, because I can't afford a holiday now, but every year they went there and we were able to ski, get pissed and talk about the meaningless science that we engaged in. And all of them have no funds now, because this is New Zealand and they're just a subsidiary of the Empire. Right then, bye bye Cliff. Okay, so Abraham and Isaac, it's biblical this. And you just saw the image of Cliff, and you see it again in these lovely fine art paintings. Okay, so Isaac is Abraham's son. And in the twisted stories that the Pizzos write and the Bible authors write and fake up, Abraham is asked at one point to kill his son rather than to give all of his family's assets to his firstborn, and that is the firstborn, yeah, circumcision issues and the angel of death that goes around looking to kill them, and all the fear-mongering stories that we get that means that we can never have civilization. I'm not sure why this is very I don't know how the gods do this, but the Abraham that's depicted with the knife in the air above the throat of Isaac is a dead ringer for the Cliff Abraham that you've just seen. And I showed him the images when I came home and discovered them, and it's just like the Black family and their presence at turning the water into wine at Canaan. It's just uncanny. Okay, and you know, here we go. Is it gonna? There he is, Cliff Abraham. There's the knife. Yeah, and that is the order to kill his own son. And that is the twisted nature of the biblical literature as it was written. It's uncanny, the likeness. And Cliff agreed. And he said, when I said, are you related to that Abraham? And he said, of course I am, George. Aren't we all? Now they just lop off the foreskin. Okay, and you can do that with the knife, and you can do it in a totally bacterial threat manner. Yeah, you suck the blood once you've removed the foreskin. Okay, That's the videos I've made on all of the bizarre religious rules that mean that we can never love our neighbours. Instead, we profiteer from mass genocides everywhere we go. And those 12 tribes have long since been slaughtered, yeah, and taken over by the Ashkenazi Jews that are the Rothschilds and the leading Illuminati, and all of the poor Jews are dead centuries ago. And now all of the leading prime ministers in Israel, yeah, have the art galleries from all of the great conflicts that they engineer using these methods. Okay? And Cliff, because he knows I'm so political, when I write to John Key and tell him that all of my correspondence on the corruption has been sent to them, he is good enough to write back to me with and to John Key and acknowledge that he's received all of my correspondence. Because the Kiwis have a very insecure temperament. Yeah, the Brits are able to walk all over them. And that's why I played the God Save New Zealand song at the beginning. Polytechnic and university totally under the hands of the profiteers, with the English-speaking or Irish accents, out of Bristol and out of Musselburgh, where I think Rifkind no, maybe not Rifkind, it's the one with the bushy eyebrows that debates with Salmond the Scottish referendum outcome. And when we lost to the mathematicians in the best research initiatives for that country in that 4 or 5 year period, the person who was on the jury was a Lib Dem out of Britain, I forget his name, also a massive profiteer, and out there so he can become, like Shania Twain, one of the land-grabbing millionaires that did not exist in 2004 when I first went there. No millionaires at all. Shania, the treasonous, ordinary working person, is the first. She did that with the help of Helen Clark, the totally deviant owner who sells their country, yeah, to the people that they work for. Totally lawless. Right, bye bye Abraham and Isaac. Nice one, Isaac, that you were able to escape that. Okay, psychology staff, Harleen Hayne. She was the new Vice Chancellor after David Skegg. I think is David Skegg is that one. He solves the menace that tobacco is dangerous. And Harleen is a professor of teenage risk. None of them will do anything to expose the way the world is run. And she's from the warmongering institutions in America with the Alpha Kappa Gamma stuff. Yeah, that's the Britney Spears brotherhood and sororities issues. Yeah, all of them think that if you can parade around with your cloak on and you can get a knighthood, that you're a world hero. They do not appreciate that they are now stealing those world heroes from the children that they are in charge of. And she's a professor of teenage fucking risk. Okay. And that's Cliff Abrahams. Professor Abraham, not the religious Abrahams, yeah, aren't we all from the same family out of America? Okay, so Harleen is the new boss and Helen is rising up that food chain. Okay, and all of them do research that is totally meaningless. They've put electrodes into rodent or even cat brains to see what the reaction is going to be. I've lost my apple. That cat issue became an issue in Wales for some of my students, and now that I've launched the thing about the head of the MRC and the animal research stuff, they're using pigs to rear human organ replacement strategies all over the newspapers since I reported the NHS frauds on the weekend. Okay?
Yeah.
As long as you can write it up and get it published, you will score. Yeah. All of them are totally on the slide because the government is much cleverer than them. Thank you, Simran, for your constancy. I believe that is an Indian trait, and all of the things. No, let's not go there. Yeah, he worked in the drug safety units, and he's now in the Christchurch departments, still slaving away. Nobody gets a job for life, because if you work for 5 years or more in the same institution, you're entitled to a job. There are no funds, and everything is a calamitous slide then. Like my student in Aberdeen, who's now working as a volunteer in India. Yeah, and that is one of, that was the first PhD student that I processed at Imperial College London. I will not give you her name, because she can't get a job now. She's working as a fucking volunteer, because that is the threat, that if you do loads of good work in the same institution for 10 or 15 years, instantly the government now proclaim that you have to give them a job. There is no funding for it because all of the central banks are being scammed, like every one of the stories I tell you. Okay, bye bye, Harleen. Okay, who's this one? Pharmacy. We've shown you Tucker. I cannot find images of Sonia anywhere. Oh, and David Jones, because he's a friend of Omar Sharif. Okay? David Jones has been written out of Otago University's history totally. This is a plant to cover him. Chair of Biomaterial Sciences, School of Pharmacy, Queen's University, Secretary in Belfast. Yeah, in the Emerald Isle. Contact details in the University of Otago phone book. There is no Emeritus Professor Jones or any images of him in his horsey cowboy boots. Yeah, from South Africa. I don't know if the woman that came forward and talked to me might even have been a relative last night. She's charming. Absolutely charming. And we talked about our friends in Cape Town and all of those South African places who now live in Hertfordshire. Yeah, and do not talk to me at all. They're the ones that shared the Home Alone jokes with me. Yeah, and their sisters are alleged to be working in really dangerous places out in the Far East. Oh no, they're in the Middle East, in Dubai actually. Yeah, living a life in poverty. And that is, yeah, my best friends in life. And they were the people that we used to visit every time we went to Rothschild, Hertfordshire. And he's the only one of the people that I know down there, because he's South African or Rhodesian, that I did not, that was not a member of the Rothschild profiteering boards. He's still a hard working scientist, plays tennis. That made me a little bit nervous. And his wife used to tell me the stories about the shootings in the supermarkets in Tring that are run by the Rothschilds. And that's Tring that we married in. And that's me in my academic gear, ever so proud of myself. The gear that I should have worn there was my Harriet Watt colours, and it's cancer pink. Yeah, I was really lucky that my machismo allowed me to get pictured in revolutionary red instead. Okay, so David Jones, my boss, has disappeared from the crime scene. He played bridge with Lawrence of Arabia, and I'll show you that. And that was in Auckland, where the Rothschild Trust is run in Parland. Okay, other people, microbiology, Otago. This will be Frank Griffin again, probably. Oh no, it's the whole of the department, and we can see all sorts of names that are ever so familiar. Okay, Loach, Coleman, okay, Crammond, Clark, whole of the Celtic football team we can put together here, and McBurney's, the Ushers of the Usher Hall fame. Yeah, they came and met me in the streets of Kelso, a massive financial dynasty. Okay? Morgans. Mercers. McConnells. Kemps. Frank Griffin. Flemings. Husseins. Cooks. Brookses of the Innsbruck region, okay? Finnerans. In the Usual Suspect movie. And the boss now is Clive Runson. Not sure why. Everything I do is in the quest to find David Jones. No longer even an emeritus label for him. He was the dean when I negotiated my contract. He tried to disgrace me when I went to India. Yeah. And I came back, I can't remember what the story was, but it was about me having a junket on the budget that I was given for that visit. Okay, and he's the one that runs G4S and has been taken out of everything in the public eye because he's from South Africa, and the previous Vice Chancellor was from South Africa. Yeah, and all of it is totally twisted. He lives in a wooden hut, but has a second home in that beautiful area. He lived where that painting was drafted. Yeah, looking over the beautiful coastline that is National Park, probably owned by Prince Charles. Right then, we're going to run out of time. Bye-bye, Microbiology Department. What is this one? I'm going to speed up because I want you to see my attempts to find my PA with her tits out at the pharmacy party and the revelations and the analogies with the Devil's Advocate film. Okay, so here is honorary degrees. So this is the only thing I can find about David Jones, that he's been given an emeritus professorship. I can't see that there. Anyway, let's move on. So David Jones has been replaced by another one in the pharmacy department. Yeah, none of what we did together I can expose. I cannot show you his image. He had a heart attack before I left. Okay. And the students that I worked with were leaping. And another one, I forget what his name is, but he's on the Rothschilds boards. Yeah, and he was from Vietnam and he wanted to work on Agent Orange, and Helen Nicholson chucked him out and made him go. Here's Omar. David Jones, Dr. Jones of G4S, massive profiteering. Yeah, that's the Dr. Jones and the people that are in the Miss Scott movies, in the Notting Hill film. Okay, all of the story is my story, and all of it is shared by Hollywood, and all of the concepts that Englishmen abroad can help are totally, and this is an Arab abroad who's risen to the ranks of Dr. Jones with the cowboy boots on for the Piso family in Auckland. Right, God save New Zealand. Bye bye Omar. This is David Skegg. He also dropped out of my list. He was a friend of that woman who became the professor in drug safety and was booted out, but because he's retired now and he's bailed out of all communications on every, he's an OBE and he's a fellow of the Royal Society of New Zealand. Yeah, that's the Queen's decisions. Yeah, he works for the British American Tobacco opposition. It's quite uncanny. And when we went to dinner at his pad, I took a bottle of wine with me thinking I was being polite and conventional, and he would not take it, and I had to get it from the butler as we went out of his massive mansion that they still have in these colonial places. And he's a fellow of the Royal Society. As soon as I get political and begin to expose why all of the universities have no funding, he bails out for loyalty to the Queen and the people that corruptedly asset stripped the whole of the nation. Let's get to the devil. Okay, this is the New Zealand Herald now, and it's an article on floods. Because every time I expose them, and every time I write to that massive list of, I can't remember what I call them, New Zealand good guys is on my email system. Okay, all of the people that you've seen already are on the list. The people that got the cancers and went to Ireland. Thank you to the people that told me that their names were associated with the place where we went to on holiday in Ireland. And they're the anti-corruption people that come from Hoyk, okay? And thank you to the man from Hoyk who declared that my dad, that my dad might be able to learn something about the innocent side of my campaign and everything I'm trying to do for the world. He's my dad's best mate now. The others were all golfers and they're all in the grave. Oh, with one exception. And they're in the Brown lineage. There's the flooding wreaks havoc in Dunedin. It happens ever such a lot. Yeah, and it coincides with everything I release about John Key's treason and the John Key lookalike who was in the Parliament building here. Yeah, and the Herbisons had it right up to the middle of the garden in the last floods. So, okay, and that's the people from Cambridge that played ping pong with us and are the masters of neuroscience, where you can now stick an electrode in a single cell, tweak a sensory here on the arm or the tail of the species that you're studying, and study the interactions with that single cell in the brain. None of them get ever so close to why the world is now in an economic disaster zone, and why the central bank in the beehive in Wellington, the icon for Great Britain, is still running the money through the Rothschild institutions. That is the Wellington joke about the Battle of Waterloo. Right then. So my PA was a body double for Connie Nielsen, and I cannot find her in any of the listings. She went from the pharmacology department to the proctor's department when they began to turn on me. There are loads of people called Sonia, and the searches get ever so sophisticated at the beginning. Yeah, I looked for the Department of Pharmacology, University of Otago, and this is the last venture, looking for her with her tits out, totally pissed, as she made a fool of me at the Christmas party on the top floor of Frederick Building in Frederick Street. Okay, and she's totally been disappeared. None of my colleagues will tell her what my name is, and even the person that helped me save the department by running all of the teaching, he's a man called Martin. He was ever so efficient. And I now use the OneNote that he tried to impose on me, but because I was a computer phobic, I refused to do it. And all of that, Martin, thank you ever so much for all of your time. Right then. So, Sonia cannot be found. She's a dead ringer for the woman in the Devil's Advocate movie, and I'll show you that now. Okay? Famous Freemasons. This is Frank again. Yeah, and all the royals around him are in part of that dismemberment team. Let's show you the Devil's Advocate stuff, because we've seen this already when the music was playing at the beginning. I'm going to get finished. I will publish on my webpage my response to John Ashton in the letter. Okay, there's the Devil's Advocate. He's a dead ringer for the man that appears all the time in the supermarket when I talk about the Devil's Advocate film, for the janitor at Kelso High School, where the headmistress is called Miss Mackay, and the whole of it is a joke. And that is the body double for my technician that worked for Apple. Where's my Apple gone? Oh, there's my Apple. Okay, yeah, that's the Apple computers run by the Jobs, who died really young too. Okay, and so his name was Murray C. Word. Okay, I will not tell you what his surname is. He's the one that worked for Apple and raked in the expenses and the bungs, and he ended up working in the Department of Computing once he'd resigned from me because he could not work with me. He's the one that said, tell no secrets, tell no lies. He's a magician. Yeah, okay, right then. And that's the devil's advocate that plays the man that is the godfather. And let's just see further down. Connie Nielsen with her tits out like Mark P.A. Sonia at the pharmacy Christmas party. No tits so far. And she worked at the bar in the place, the birthplace for Robbie Burns. Yeah, same, they've got the same villages, and there's another one of my technician that was getting the money for Apple. And that's another morphing image of what the devil looks like in real life. Okay, and there's Connie Nielsen. I think that the tits will be further along because the search terms get a little bit more explicit then. Final scenes reporter Connie Nielsen. So if we go that way, she's lovely. Yeah, and she's the one in that movie that is about the nymphomaniac. And all of that is about fishermen and nymphs in the fishing world. Yeah, it's all my story. And she's the brother of the devil's, the sister of the devil's son. Nothing left to hide in her filmmaking career. And she is the emperor's sister in the Gladiator film. And that must be the one, not final scenes. I can't see her breasts. Believe me, there is nothing left to hide in her story. Okay? And all of it is really, really sinister. But thank you to John Ashton. I could start reading the thing. And I'd love to talk to Sonia again. She was lovely. Several children already, several marriages. Dead ringer for Connie Nielsen. Okay? But she and Dr. Jones, yeah, and the Notting Hill people have been totally disappeared from the institutional transcripts. And I've shown you the movies on the other departmental heads and Kurt Cruz and the Nazi links to the Rothschilds of Texas. And that's where Pfizer Texas runs from. Okay? So, I'm going to stop there. Let's see if we can find Connie's tits. Yeah, because my images of the woman that plays the Queen all the time have become quite a legend. Reporter Connie Nielsen. Connie Nielsen tits out. Okay, that's not Connie Nielsen. That's quite explicit. That's what the other movie's like. And there she is with her brother, the devil, yeah, and the man that is the dead ringer for my chief technician, and the man who works for Apple, is the last scene when they think that all of this is ended, and that he's going to New York and shooting himself in the head, because the devil wants him to be the next devil in the generations, yeah, yeah. He then sees my chief technician lookalike, and that is actually the new role for the devil. So in the local town, the pressman is the devil. Do you get it? It's the same stories I've told you about the Thompson twins and Reuters and all of the stuff. I now believe that the gods are ever so inspiring, and that everyone now is aware that I will never stop telling the truth. Yeah. And it's ever so fulfilling to do some real work. And Frank has made, that's Frank, the famous Freemason in New Zealand. That's why I played the God Save New Zealand movie. Yeah, he's made $66 million for the agriculture in New Zealand. All of the agriculture in New Zealand is run by Britain. Every one of the ag research people that we met are English people. Yeah, Frank's Irish. He started in colonial sub-Saharan Africa.
right down near the Rhodesian crime scene, yeah, and all the apartheid stuff has been confirmed to be still 4% of people have access to electricity in Africa. All of them get the tropical illnesses because they cannot do the drainage and they cannot do the stuff, because everybody now is thinking of taxing the people in those mud huts for breathing. Yeah, that's the green scam run by Bill Clinton, and all the videos I've made on that have been shut down. Okay, I'm gonna stop. That's Frank Griffin, who promised to have a golf game with me in the last fortnight in New Zealand. He did not show up. The head of biochemistry, his son is also a psychiatrist now working in Dunedin. And they will not let my innocent fishing friends, yeah, who worked with me every weekend, fished with me almost every weekend, yeah, and they are from Moorbattle. Yeah, and when we were in New Zealand, Moorbattle had the biggest ever flood, and the Tweed had a bigger flood than any that we've seen so far. Okay, in the recent events, and those floods are occurring now globally. Look, another local hero just happens to be on the same page as the moonshot people that bailed out, yeah? Gus Grissom, the traitor in the moonshot program, he later died in a fire. Haig, Douglas, Field Marshal, First Earl Haig, these are the icons for stealing of the world's freedom. And I told you about the revolutionaries who went to America and became, yeah, the famous Georges Danton, yeah, who's alleged to have his head lopped off, but instead they're heroes for the royals that run the global Freemasons and create all wars. Funds come to the royal Freemasons from all sides, and they are then manipulated themselves by the money lenders that Jesus, who never lived, warned us about. Bye bye.